Welcome back to my class students, class 5 subject mathematics. So we'll be continuing with our topic, our chapter, that is factors and multiples. We'll be learning about LCM today. What LCM is nothing but least common multiple. You have already learned about HCF, that is highest common factor. You have learned about highest common factor. Now we can learn about least common multiple. Least common multiple is LCM of two or more given numbers is the smallest number which is the multiple of both the numbers. What do you mean by LCM? Two or more given numbers. If they are given two or more given numbers, it is the smallest number which is the multiple of both that numbers. For example, here you can see in the picture here. Now, this is one circle. This is number 12 circle. This is another circle, number 20 circle. They have said you to find the LCM of 12 and 20. How will you find the LCM? First, find the factors of 12. Factors of 12 are 2 into 2 into 3. Next, factors of 20 are 2 into 2 into 5. Write down the factors in the circle. Now observe which are the common factors. Observe which are the common factor. Is 3 common here? No. 2 is common in both the numbers, that is 12 and 20. So we will take 2 here once. LCM equals 2 into 2 because both the numbers have the common factor. So 2 should be written only one time. That is 2 into 2 into 3. What is remaining now? 3 and 5 into 3 into 5. So multiply all the digits given here and we get the LCM. Did you get, students? The shaded and unshaded parts show the LCM of two numbers. Now we can go to exercise 5. First, find the LCM of each set of numbers given below using prime factorization method. You already know what do you mean by prime factorization. I have taught you what do you mean by prime factorization. So these are the numbers given 4, 6 and 8. So what is the first step here? First step is find the prime factorization of the numbers. That is, take 4 separately. Find the factors of 4. Next, find the factors of 6. Find the factors of 8 by prime factorization method. What are the factors we get for 4? 2 into 2 into 1. Next, what are the factors of 6? 2 into 3 into 1. We have written the factors of 6. What are the factors of 8? 2 into 2 into 2 into 1. We have written all the factors. Now, observe the factors and see which are common in all the three numbers. Now, 2 is common in all the three numbers, so I have taken 2. Next, observe the factors because here three numbers are given. Next, come to the two numbers. Two numbers which are common. Two factors which are common in both the numbers. Now, this 2 is common here. Again, this 2 is common here. So, I'll be taking here 2 once. Only one time. I'll be taking again 2 one time because it is common in both the numbers. This 2 is taken only one time because this is common in all the three numbers. Now, just write down the numbers which are left out. 3 into 2. 3 into 2 we have written. Multiply all the digits and you will get the LCM of the given number by prime factorization method. Now, students, you have learned about HCF. Although HCF is mentioned as largest or greatest or highest number, it is always the smaller than LCM. HCF is always smaller than the LCM of the given number. Now here, the LCM we got here is 24. If you want to find the HCF of this, you will get the lower number for this. This is the highest number for LCM what you have got for this number. If you do the same numbers HCF, you will get the lower number. Don't go by the name that is highest common factor. Even though it is highest common factor, we will get the HCF lower number itself. That is the answer what we get in HCF is lower number. Answer what we get in LCM is the highest number. Did you get, students? Now the second sum is given. Find the LCM of number 35 and 75. What is the first step, students? Do the prime factorization. I have done the factorization of number 35 and I got the factors. I have written the factors. Next, I have done the prime factorization of 75. I have got the factors and I have written the factors. What is the next second step? Observe the factors and see which is common in both the numbers. Now here, only 5 is common. So I have taken 5 only once. Instead of writing 5 into 5, because it is common in both the numbers, I have written 5 only once. Into 7, the next number. Next into 5, into 3. I got the LCM of this number. Now third one also, 144 and 200. The same way I have done. I have done the prime factorization of 144 and 200. I have taken the factors. I have observed which is the common factor here. That is 2 is common. Again 2 is common. Again 2 is common. I have encircled the factors which are common. And I have written 2 into 2 into 2. Now write down the factors which are remaining. In number 144, 2 into 3 into 3 is remaining. 200, 5 into 5 is remaining. I got the LCM 3600. Next D1th I am doing 40, 60 and 80. I have got the factors. I have written all the factors. I have observed the common factors. Here, because it is given three numbers, the numbers which are common in all the three I have written. Now what is the second step? Observe the numbers which are common in two. Two numbers which are common. Now 2, 3, 2 again here is common in all the 3 I have taken. 2 is common in all the 3 I have taken. 5 is common in all the 3 numbers I have taken. Next, why did I not take 2 into 2? I took this 2 only once because it is repeated in 2 numbers. I have underlined. Understand this? Encircled is common in all the 3 numbers. Underline is common in 2 numbers. Which I have not done anything, that is a common factor I have taken. I have taken everything and I got the LCM. Next we will go to second main. Find the LCM. Find the LCM of numbers given below using common division method. You have done this common division method in HCF also. I will just tell you the difference in HCF what you did. Difference in LCM what you are going to do. Now they have given you the number 42 and 56. You should find the LCM of the numbers by common division method. I have taken the numbers. See, 221s are 42, 228s are 56. It is divisible by 2, table 2. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. Next, see common number which is divisible by 21 and 28. 7 is divisible by 3, that is 7 3s are 21, 7 4s are 28. Now we have 3 and 4. Is any number divisible by 3 and 4? Common number, that is any table, we have 3 and 4. No, we don't have the same table which is divisible by 3 and 4. So in HCF what you do, you stop your division method here. But in LCM, you should not stop your division method here until you get 1. Did you get not stop till here until you get 1? But in HCF, you should be stopping till here and you will take the factors. So here, 3 ones are 3 again. 4 as it is I am writing. Next 4 ones are 4. So what are the factors? 2 into 7 into 3 into 4. I got the LCM 168. Did you get the difference, students? How did we find out HCF? And how are we finding out the LCM here? Next, second here. So we should find out the LCM of these numbers, that is 12, 20 and 32 by common division method. So this 12, 20 and 32 is divisible by 2, that is 2 6s are, 2 10s are, 2 16s are. Again all the 3 numbers are divisible by 2, 2 3s are, 2 5s are, 2 8s are. Now this 3, 5 and 8 is not divisible by same table. So I am taking 3 1s are 3, 5 as it is and 8 as it is. Again 5 and 8 are not divisible by same table. So again 5 1s are 1 as it is, 5 1s are 5 and 8 as it is. Again 8 1s are 8. So what are the factors I am getting? 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 8. I got the answer as 480. So please do exercise 5 in your classwork. Now let us go to what is the relationship between HCF and LCM. Now they have given you two numbers, that is 36 and 42. They have said you to find the LCM of that number as well as the HCF of that number. So what is the first step? We should do prime factorization. After doing prime factorization, I get the factors as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Then the number 42, after doing prime factorization, I get the factors 2 into 3 into 7. Now observe which are common. Observe which are common. To do HCF, observe which are common, that is 2 is common here and 3 is common. Just take the numbers which are common, that is 2 into 3, we get the HCF as 6. Now to do LCM, to find out the LCM, we should take all the numbers. First observe which are common, that is 2 into 3 is common. Next which are remaining? 2, again 3, again 7. Did you get students? See, 2 is common, again 3 is common. Which are remaining factors here? 2 into 3 into 7. So this LCM we got as 252. You have observed here. See, the HCF is the lower number and the LCM what we got is the greater number. So first number into second number equals HCF into LCM. What is the first number? 36. Second number 42. 36 into 42 we get 1512. HCF we got 6 and LCM we got 252. 6 into 252, we get the same answer, 1512. So the product of two numbers is equal to the product of their HCF and LCM. Did you get the relationship between HCF and LCM? In this chapter, exercise 6 and exercise 7 is excluded from the portions. You need not do the exercise 6 and exercise 7. Just for your details, for your knowledge, I have explained you the relationship between HCF and LCM. Jazakallahu khair.